My name is Chelsea Alexander. I'm 16 years old and I attend Addington Friends School. I will be reading you here in John 6:63 and Romans 8:1. John 6:63 says, "It is the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life." Romans 8:1 says, "There is now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. In Christ we have life, and life more abundantly." His word says, "In life, Jesus, help me, God." His word says that there is now no condemnation to him which is in Christ Jesus. This means he won't condemn us. In other words, he won't cut us off and leave us. He told us to trust in him and not into man where there is no help. Man will condemn, man will leave you, but God will always have your back. He will always have you wrapped in his arms, carrying you. We do not have to feel guilty after we have asked for forgiveness, because he already forgiven us. But in order to be wrapped up in his grace, you must walk after the Spirit and not after the flesh. God says, "There is a way which seemeth right to a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death." Proverbs 14:12 says, "Following after the flesh awards is no good thing, but it is the spirit that quickeneth, and the flesh profiteth nothing." The flesh is the thing that is telling you to do those things which you know are not right. The flesh is what gets you in trouble. To escape this fleshly nature, meditate in his word day and night, that you may be a plant in rivers of water, steadfast and immovable, so that the devil can't have you. You must feed the spirit man daily, so your flesh can be weaker. When you're in the flesh, you cannot please God. Amen. Our purpose on earth is to please God. And how can you do that if you're carnally minded? Amen. Which Romans 8:7 says, is enmity with God. God gives us peace if we follow his spirit, if we trust him, if we give him all. All we have to do is serve him, seek his face, and lead a life of righteousness. He will supply us with what we need. Fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. Every sinner has his debt. Just because the sinner looks like their life is good doesn't mean it is. Everything that glitter isn't gold.
That's right. Amen.
Because they shall soon be cut down like the grass and withers the green earth. If you wait on God, you will inherit the whole earth. Running with the crowd is not worth it, believe me. If you delight yourself in his word, Peter 2:15 says, "For so is the will of God, that with well-doing you may put to silence the ignorance of foolish men. They may laugh at you now, but be not weary in well-doing, for in due season you shall reap if you faint not." Amen. God loves you, and you are a royal priesthood, a holy nation. You didn't choose God. God chose you.
Amen.
Now I challenge you all to lift your hands right now and say, "I will do as the Lord will have me to do.
I will do as the Lord will have me to do.
My soul says yes.
My soul says yes.
My mind says yes.
My mind says yes.
My heart says yes.
My heart says yes.
And I will do what you want me to do.
And I will do what you want me to do.
If you lead me.
If you lead me.